something called anaphylaxis. So right. I want you to walk over to our 3D image wall. I'm sure everybody has heard of anaphylaxis. I saw a friend of mine experience it with her son. Frightening moments for right. that mom, let me tell you, doctor.
Yeah, that can be very, very, very scary. And this first screenshot here, we're seeing a patient that his eyes are puffy, the face is swollen, a lot of redness. And this is very typical for what a person looks like just visually with anaphylaxis. There are obviously other manifestations of anaphylaxis that we'll see in the next screen. This is showing the inside of the airway. On this picture, what we're seeing is a lot of swelling in the nasal cavity, a lot of mucus production. We're also seeing a lot of swelling in the oral pharynx here. And we're also seeing a lot of swelling in the lower airway down here in the trachea. And the next screen, this is basically what anaphylaxis is. We have these immune cells that are releasing histamine. And histamine is was designed originally to protect us against insects, worms, and other infections. But in modern day, we don't have those things around. So histamine is now released by our bodies inadvertently when we have these reactions to antigens. On this slide, we're seeing basically a collapse of the lower airway, the distal trachea and the bronchioles. We're seeing a lot of collapse here. And that is what you would hear, the wheezing or the stridor you mm-hmm. might hear when somebody has anaphylaxis. If somebody has anaphylaxis, that's what you would hear. And then this would be a good sign that you should give them an antihistamine, Benadryl, and you should also give them an EpiPen if you have one.